Hello, in this video we're going to show you how to install OpenWrt on the Xiaomi 4A router. At the end we're going to go through a Debrick method just in case something goes wrong. As you can see, I'm using a VM version of Ubuntu, and we're going to go straight to the GitHub page for the exploit, which you can find in the description, and we're going to git clone that repo. Next, we're going to move into the OpenWrtInvasion directory with the command on the screen, and then we're going to install Python and pip, if you haven't already, with the following commands. Now we can install the requirements required for the exploit. So just type in the command on screen and it should install the parts required. Now open up a browser and go to your router's configuration page. You can see that the normal address is on screen, and then log in as you normally would. We're going to pay special attention to the IP address and the stock code that you get here. We're going to make sure we're still in the same directory. So I'm CDing again, and then I'm going to run the exploit with this command. It's going to ask you for your IP address, which you know from where you logged in. And your stock code, which we can also get from the browser. So I'm just going to copy and paste that. Once complete, it will tell you to log in via telnet. So I like to open a new terminal and just type in telnet, followed by your IP address. And when prompted, we're going to type the username of root. If for any reason you fail to log in, it's not uncommon, you can retry the exploit. If that still fails, try rebooting the router, but remember, if you do, the stock code will change, so you'll have to recopy that. Now that you're logged in, we'll go back to the GitHub page, read carefully the information about the different types of firmware images. Once you're happy, we're going to go CD into the TMP directory, and then we're going to curl whatever firmware image we want. I'm using one made by Zorro, but you can use whichever one you want. At the end of that, we're going to put --, output firmware, and that just changes the file name once it's downloaded to firmware. Makes it easier for us to work with. Next, you should check your SHA checksum, and if it's different from where you've downloaded it from, make sure you re-download it. And then we install with the following command. The command will take a long time, so just sit tight. You're going to need to wait for at least 15 minutes. Don't touch it at all, and hopefully when you come back, both lights should be blue. If they're not blue, then we might need to go through the Debrick method at the end of the video, but hopefully they are. You'll still see it saying rebooting on the screen, but we can go to our browser now and go to the new address, which is 1.1. You may need to unplug your Ethernet cable and replug it back in to get this. And then just log in without a password. The user is root. And then hopefully you should have your OpenWrt router working. Congratulations. Not all firmware images work, so sometimes it goes wrong. But if you need to debrick it, download the Debrick tool from the description, and you're going to need to set your IP to 1.2. If you don't know how to do this, click on the link at the top of the screen and go to one of my other videos. It should show you how to do that. Once downloaded, extract the tool onto your desktop and run the file. Make sure you select the IP address that's 1.2. Now you need to unplug your router. And as we plug it back in, we're going to push the reset button and hold it. And hold it until the light flashes slowly. Now you can release. Now we go back to the screen and we press online on the server. And after a few seconds, the router should take the firmware, which is preloaded within that folder. Now leave it. We're going to leave it for at least 10 minutes. And after that, you can reattempt to install whatever version you want. Obviously, I would try a different firmware image. Hopefully this video has helped. Let me know how you get on in the comment section below. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks a lot.